Hey, it's Rob with Inyo Pools. Today I wanted to show you how to determine the voltage of your pool pump motor or your spa pump motor. We get this question a lot with customers who are either in the process of purchasing a motor or they've got the new motor and they're going to wire it up and they're not sure of the voltage. Wanted to show you a couple ways you can determine that and help you out. First thing that you want to do is check out the label on the pump. And on this spa pump, it says volts 115, so it's real simple. So you'd want to get a 115 volt replacement. On the pool motors, especially the lower horsepower, 3/4, 1.5, you'll notice that a lot of them are dual voltage. So this one's dual voltage, says 230, 115. So what you do with the power off, go ahead and take the cap off of the back of the motor, and look here, most of these new Century models have a dial, and you can see where it says either 230 or it's set on 115. So check that out. That's real simple. So if yours is set on 230, you'll wire up the new one 230. But on some of the older ones that don't have that dial, you'll have two wiring diagrams. You'll have one for low voltage and one for high voltage, usually next to each other. And so you just want to match that up. So you'd look at the wiring diagram for, let's say, high voltage, and then you'd go to the back and see how it's wired. So if the if it said, hey, the black one goes to terminal 1 and the red one goes to terminal 3, let's say, for example, and that matched the 230 or the high voltage diagram, then your old motor is set up for 230. All right, if you run into a scenario where the motor label is either missing or you can't read it to determine the voltage, what you can do is walk over to the control box or the breaker panel and take a look at the breaker where the pump is connected to. So on this one, it's labeled. It tells me filter and pump is on 3 and 5, which is a double pull breaker, which 99.9% of the time means your pump's gonna be wired on 230 volt. If it's on a single pull breaker, then it's definitely 115. But like I said, there's a very small chance that your pump could be wired on 115 if somebody switched it at some point. So what you could do is, first of all, I'd make sure the power is off to everything so you don't harm yourself. And then take off the this panel, and then we'll take a look and see how it's wired. All right, if you're looking at that double pull breaker and you notice you see a black and a red on the two load lines, it's definitely wired for 230. For some reason you get in here and you see only one load line connected and a neutral line and it goes back to your pump, that means it's wired for 115. But again, that's highly unlikely. You know, most of the time it's going to be these kind of breakers are going to be wired for 230 volt. All right, if you don't have a control box out by your equipment, you just have a timer. Most of the timers are going to be labeled 115 or 230 volts. So open up the door, usually on the inside of the door, there's a label and it'll tell you the voltage. If that label's missing, or maybe you have a digital timer that's dual voltage, you're going to have to use a multimeter to check the voltage. And we can show a picture of how to test that. But basically, you know, follow the lines that run from your pump back to the timer, and then set your multimeter on V for volts, and then use the probes on the terminals where the lines coming from your pump are connected, and then that'll tell you whether it's 115 or 230. Hopefully that helps you figure out the voltage of your motor. If you have any questions about this or anything pool or spa related, visit us over at inyopools.com. Thanks for watching.